Your other option of getting around quickly is relying on taxis to zip you around from one place to another. But they're pricey even if you're not being overcharged. And unlike New York City, you don't hail a taxi in the middle of the street. I'm not saying many won't stop, but that's not the taxi protocol in Italy. Like at the Termini station taxi stop, you'll find most taxis waiting for passengers at dedicated taxi stops, like this one in Piazza della Repubblica, not too far from the Termini station. It helps to ask around in advance the average cost of taxi fares in between major attractions, either from fellow travelers or your hotel. There are also websites that can calculate taxi fare estimates in top international cities like worldtaximeter.com, which includes Rome. This leaves us with public transportation, which in Italy is inexpensive, efficient, and reliable, at least most of the time. This includes the metro subway system, public buses, and trains. The metro is divided into two lines, the blue line and red line, that serve locations in a crisscross layout across the city. If you find yourself in the vicinity of a metro stop that happens to also take you to your chosen destination, it's a much faster means of transport than taking a bus that makes frequent stops and is beholden to traffic conditions. For example, if you're at the Vatican and your next destination is the Spanish Steps, you can take the Ottaviano San Pietro Red Line metro stop to the Spanish Steps that's only two stops away. However, if you decide to go to the Colosseum instead, you'd have to get off at the Termini station and switch to the Blue Line that's also a quick two stops to the Colosseum. You don't have to exit the station at Termini to switch from the red line to the blue line, just follow the directions posted throughout. Also, hold on to your stamped ticket when you change trains in case you might need to present it again at the next turnstile. A metro ticket also serves as a bus ticket, and it's valid for 75 minutes after you validated it, either at the metro turnstile or bus stamp machine. It's good for one metro ride, meaning you can change metro trains, but once you exit a metro station, you can't reuse it for another metro ride. But it's good for unlimited bus use within the 75-minute time frame. It helps to have a map of Rome and the metro stops with you at all times. Trains run approximately 4 to 10 minutes, from 5:30 a.m. to 11:30 p.m., 12:30 a.m. on Saturdays. It's best to avoid rush hour when locals commute to and from work. A sardine can is spacious compared to what you experience on a metro train at 6 p.m. If you do find yourself crammed in during rush hour and people are blocking the door as you try to exit, simply say permesso so they move aside for you. As always, avoid becoming a victim of pickpockets by taking caution with your belongings. Keep your handbags and backpacks close to your body and don't place any valuables in easy-to-reach pockets. Taking the bus is another efficient way to get around not only in Rome, but in all of Italy's large cities. They can be crowded, you might find yourself standing quite a bit and sometimes squished in there, but taking the bus also offers you an inexpensive and practical way of sightseeing around the city, especially the streets you may never have a chance to walk through. Bus tickets and prices differ from city to city, and you need to purchase your bus tickets from the city you're in. Your Rome bus tickets won't work in Florence. Everywhere in Italy, you can buy your bus tickets from the tabacchi or tobacco shops. You may also buy maps of bus routes from the tabacchi shops as well. You can find the tabacchi shops with a big T sign in front of the shops. In Rome, an increasing number of buses also offer a ticket machine where you can purchase your ticket right on the bus. In some cases, you can buy your bus tickets from the bus driver at higher cost, of course. I was able to do this in Florence and Cortona since there were no tabacchi shops nearby. However, I wouldn't attempt to ask a Roman bus driver for a ticket. Somehow, I have the feeling they don't carry bus tickets. Or they just look like they don't. Be sure to validate your bus ticket once you enter the bus and keep your stamp ticket with you, especially if you need to change buses within a 75-minute time frame that the ticket is valid. I've seen people avoid validating their bus tickets to save a euro. However, I've also seen controllers jump on and off buses checking for tickets. If you don't have a ticket or you haven't validated yours, you can get a fine of at least 100 euros. You'll also notice a tram whose routes are really quite limited. The most useful trams are number 8, which goes from Trastevere to Torre Argentina and vice versa, and number 3, from San Giovanni to the Colosseum, then Termini, and vice versa. I found using it to get to Trastevere quite useful. Also abundant on the streets of Rome are hop-on, hop-off double-decker buses that go the route of tourist attractions. I was never inclined to ride one, so I have no opinion on them. If you do, I'll love to hear it. To avoid running out of bus tickets, especially if the tabacchi shops are closed, as they usually are on Sundays, you can buy a few in advance. In Rome, you can purchase single tickets valid for 75 minutes for 1 euro, a full-day ticket for unlimited bus and metro rides for 4 euros, a 3-day tourist ticket valid for unlimited use for 11 euros, and also weekly or monthly if you're on an extended stay. Just as in the metro, keep your belongings close to your body and don't keep valuables in easy-to-reach places to avoid pickpockets. The infamous bus 64 that goes to the Vatican is notorious for pickpockets who fancy absent-minded and distracted tourists. Personally, I've never had a problem on bus 64 or any bus or metro in Rome, knock on wood, but it could also be that I helped avoid becoming a victim of professional pickpockets by being aware of the people around me and extra cautious with my belongings at all times. Pickpockets aren't interested in working for their loot, so don't make it easy for them to dip their hands into your pockets or bags. One simple way to deter them is to safety pin the openings of your pockets together, as well as your bag zippers. This also prevents items from falling out of your pockets or bags unexpectedly. I found locals to be generally honest people who on more than one occasion found something I dropped on the ground and came to me to return it. So in my case, it wasn't so much the pickpockets I had to be worried about, but my own carelessness.